see actually ionization energy, if you see there will be sudden jump in ionization energy when inert gas configuration is met. So for example, take first A group. Okay, the first A group elements, in first A group elements, ionization energy 2, second ionization energy shows sudden jump. If you take example sodium from first A group element, its configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. See, normally first ionization, when compared to first ionization energy, second ionization energy will be more. See, look here, in case of sodium, if you take sodium atom, so its configuration is like this and the electron arrangement will be like this. So first orbit 2 electrons, second orbit it contains 8 electrons and third orbit will be 1 electron, and third electron possesses 1 electron in sodium atom. See, like by spending first ionization energy, I can remove one electron. So I'll remove this electron. After removal of the first electron, now what happens? This atom will get a inert gas configuration, because now this will become the outermost orbit. Now in the outermost orbit there are 8 electrons. So that means after removal of this electron, now sodium will get this configuration. Okay. Now, in order to remove the second electron from this atom, so I have to remove second electron. In order to remove a second electron from this atom, so it will be very difficult, because inert gases does not lose electron easily. Because of stable electronic configuration, they does not like to lose electron. At all, if you want to remove any electron from the inert gas, it requires very, very, very high energy. It requires large amount of energy. So generally, second ionization energy will be more than the first ionization energy. But here in this case, what happens? The second ionization energy, it is very, very large. It is very, very large than the first ionization energy, because in case of inert gas configuration, when inert gas configuration is obtained, that means in case of inert gas configuration obtained after first ionization energy. See here, after removal of first electron, so the atom is getting inert gas configuration. So that means inert gas configuration is obtained after first ionization energy. So in that case, it requires more energy. There will be sudden jump in the ionization energy. Okay, so normally it should be second ionization energy should be normally greater, but it is not that much greater. But why it is here that much greater? Because here what is happening, the sodium after removal of one electron, it is meeting, or else it is getting inert gas configuration. Whenever inert gas configuration is obtained after first ionization energy, then this will be applicable. In normal cases this is applicable, but in this case it is applicable. Okay, see, if you see the first ionization energy of sodium is 496 kilojoule per mole, but second ionization energy is nearly equal to 2081 kilojoule per mole. So there is a large difference in the first ionization energy and second ionization energy. There is a sudden jump in the ionization energy value of sodium. Okay, right. Now let us learn about the magnesium. Take one more example, magnesium. So if you see the magnesium, its configuration is 3s2. That means in magnesium atom there are 2 electrons in the outermost orbit. So by spending first ionization energy, I remove the last electron from the atom. Okay, always the last electron should electron from the outermost orbit can only be removed. The electrons from the inner orbits cannot be removed, okay, because they are closer to the nucleus and they are strongly attracted by the nucleus. Outermost orbit only are far away, they can be removed easily. Okay, so after spending first ionization energy, so I can remove this electron. Now, in order to remove this electron, I can spend some more energy. So that means, so second ionization energy also I have spent and I have removed the second electron. See, in magnesium atom, after removal of second electron, so now it is getting, after removal of these two electrons, now magnesium is getting stable inert gas configuration. So it is having 8 electrons in the valence shell. It is stable inert gas configuration. So now, if I want to remove the third electron, if I want to remove one more electron from this configuration, that means third electron from magnesium atom, so it requires very, very large amount of ionization energy. Very, very large amount of ionization energy it requires. That means, see here, after removal of two electrons, after removal of two electrons from the magnesium atom, it is now magnesium is meeting, it is getting an inert gas configuration. So whenever an inert gas configuration is it is obtained, what happens? So there will be sudden jump in the ionization energy. So there will be sudden jump in ionization energy when inert gas configuration is met. So like this. So in this way, ionization energy can be learnt like this. One more thing. Due to lanthanide contraction, the elements, of 5D series, will have more ionization energy than its above element, than their respective above element, from 4D series. For example, take tantalum and niobium, molybdenum, next one tungsten, so these are 4D elements and these are 5D elements. See, generally what happens? Generally down the group, what happens? Ionization energy should decrease. Down the group, ionization energy should decrease. But in case of 4D and 5D elements, what happens? So due to lanthanide contraction, what happens? The ionization energy increases. Generally, ionization energy should decrease in the group, but so the, here it is an exception. Due to lanthanide contraction, the elements of 5D series will have more ionization energy than their respective above elements from 40 series. So this is I mean actually tantalum should possess less ionization energy than nobelium, but due to lateral contraction tantalum is having more ionization energy than nobelium. Okay, so like this we can lateral contraction it makes the ionization energy value to increase down the group. Normally ionization energy decreases down the group, but whenever lanthanide contraction is met, so the ionization energy will increase down the group. Okay, and even actinide contraction also will also increase down the group. Right, now let us learn about the next concept. So this is about what? This is about ionization energy. Okay, and certain the factors which affect the ionization energy. So now let us learn about the next periodic property. We learn about the next periodic property known as electron affinity. Electron affinity. Electron affinity. It is also called as electron gain enthalpy. Electron gain enthalpy. Electron affinity is also called as electron gain enthalpy. Generally, it is denoted with delta EGH, electron gain enthalpy. What is electron gain enthalpy? First, we will learn about this one. Okay, the definition of this one. Suppose if there is an atom, this is the nucleus of an atom, and these are the electrons present in an atom. Okay, so like this. Suppose here, like these are electrons. So this is an atom. Let us assume. So I want to introduce an electron from the from outside into the atom. See, I want to introduce an electron from the outside into an atom. So what happens? When an electron is introduced from outside into an atom, if the nucleus is ready to accept that electron, if the nucleus is ready to show force of attraction on that electron, what happens? That electron will remain in the atom. So that particular electron will remain in the atom if the nucleus is able to show its force of attraction on the outermost. Added electron, if it is able to show force of attraction on the added electron, then that electron will remain in the atom. Otherwise, that electron cannot become the part of the atom. Okay, look here. Suppose if nucleus is showing force of attraction on that electron, always force of attraction, remember that always force of attraction leads to the loss of energy. When there is a force of attraction, there will be loss of energy. See, look here, when an electron is added to an atom from the outside, that means an electron from other atom or else from somewhere. When an electron is added to an atom, if the nucleus of that atom could able to show its force of attraction on the electron, then that electron will remain in that atom only. Otherwise, it cannot remain in that atom. So in that case, nucleus is said to be showing force of attraction. If nucleus is showing force of attraction, so there should be release of energy. That means this atom should lose some energy. This atom should lose some energy. Okay, so how much amount of energy is lost by the atom when an electron is added to it? So that lost energy is said to be electron affinity. The amount of energy an atom loses when an electron is added to an atom. Okay, so that release energy is said to be electron affinity. Okay, if you want to learn the definition of electron affinity, so it will be like this. It is nothing but the amount of energy released. The amount of energy released when an electron is added to a gaseous neutral isolated atom. The amount of energy released when an electron is added to a gaseous neutral isolated atom, so that energy is said to be, that is said to be electron affinity, or else electron gain enthalpy. That means when atom is gaining an electron, so it loses some energy. So enthalpy means energy change. So that atom will lose some energy. So that energy, the lost energy, or else the energy released, the released energy is said to be electron affinity. Generally, electron affinity, it is an exothermic process. Electron affinity is exothermic process. Generally exothermic process. That means there will be loss of energy. See, generally ionized energy, it is related to non-metal. Generally it is related to non-metals. Generally non-metal. So for the gaseous non-metal atom, an electron is added, what happens? It becomes X minus. In that process, some amount of energy is released. So that released energy is called to Ea. It is denoted with Ea sometimes. Ea or else delta Egh. So both are same. Both are same now. So this energy is said to be, the released energy is said to be electron affinity or else first electron affinity. It is an exothermic process. Suppose, listen carefully, suppose if I want to introduce one more electron, already I have introduced an electron to an atom. Now this electron, it is attracted by the nucleus. Now that electron has become a part. Now if I want to add one more electron to the same atom, what happens? See, look here, the number of positive charges, when compared to the number of positive charges, the number of negative charges are more due to the addition of one electron already. So due to this, what happens? There will be competition for the space, because in the limited space, the number of electrons should be adjusted. There will be competition for the space between the electrons. So in that case, in that circumstances, if one more electron is, if you try to add one more electron, so this atom will not accept that added electron, one more electron. Okay, so in that case, the second electron, that atom does not like to take. That means it does not show force of attraction. In order to, even then, If you want to add this electron into this atom, what we have to do? We have to reduce the force of attraction, because repulsion, because this electron will try to repel this electron, and it will try to stop this electron to enter into this atom. The force of repulsion shown by these electrons on this electron will try to prevent this electron to enter into this atom. Now, compulsorily, if you want to add this electron to this atom, what we have to do? We have to reduce the force of repulsion shown by these electrons. Okay, in order to reduce the force, that means we have to push away these electrons. These electrons we have to push away. To push away these electrons, or else to reduce the repulsion, we need to spend some energy. We have to spend some energy. That means some energy should be supplied to the atom. Some energy should be supplied to an atom to add the second electron. So that some energy should be supplied to the atom, because with this supplied energy, the repulsion forces of these electrons on this electron will reduce. Therefore, what happens? Now this electron can become the part of this atom. Okay, as a whole, of course, now after this electron has become the part of this atom, now this nucleus will show force of attraction on this. Okay, now we have to see, due to the force of attraction, whenever force of attraction is shown, what happens? Force of attraction always leads to the loss of energy. So now this atom will lose energy. See here, two things are happening. See, the atom should be supplied with some energy in order to include this electron into this atom. In order to include this electron into the atom, first initially we have supplied energy to that atom, so that the repulsive forces are removed. After inclusion of this electron into this atom, now this nucleus will show force of attraction on this added electron, second electron. As a result of force of attraction, some energy is released. Now, always remember that the energy given to the atom will be more than the energy released by the atom due to addition of atom, due to addition of electron. So that means this energy taken by the atom is more than the energy given by the atom due to addition of second electron. So as a whole, what is happening? The absorbed energy is more. Absorbed energy by the atom is more when compared to the lost energy by the atom. As a whole, what is happening? So for inclusion, for the second ion, so now the energy, what has happened? So the energy involved in this process is said to be second electron affinity. Simply we will write Ea2. What is Ea2? Second electron affinity. Ea2 means second electron affinity. What is second electron affinity? Energy involved in the when an electron is added to a uninegative gaseous isolated ion. See, look here. So actually this is a neutral atom. So whenever first electron is supplied to that atom, now that atom has become uninegative ion. now this atom, now we are going to add one more electron to this atom. That means already that atom has become uninegative atom. Okay, now we are going to supply one more electron. We are going to add one more electron to this atom. Now that atom will become X minus 2. Okay, so in this process what is happening? We are supplying energy also. So here we are supplying energy also. Are you following? So here the supplied energy, it is said to be second ionization energy. So the amount of energy supplied to the atom in order to include the second electron into this atom to form X minus 2. So that energy is said to be second ionization energy. Okay, energy involved when an electron is added to a uninegative gaseous isolated ion. So actually this is uninegative gaseous isolated ion. So to this one, if I want to add second electron, if I want to add one more electron, so I have to spend some energy. So I have to give some energy. The amount of energy given to the atom. So in that case, it is said to be second electron affinity. Sorry, not IE. It is EA. Second electron affinity. EA2. Second electron affinity. Listen, first electron affinity is it's an exothermic process. First electron affinity is exothermic, whereas second electron affinity, it is endothermic. Okay, and even EA3, EA4, etc. All are endothermic. So like this. So only first electron affinity is exothermic, and the subsequent electron affinities are endothermic in nature. So like this, electron affinity is also another factor. So we need to learn. So we will learn some more points about electron affinity in the next class. So the units, if you see the units of electron affinity are similar to ionization energy units. Okay, so we will learn some more points about electron affinity in the next class.